We are the Gujarat Technological University. Since its inception over a decade ago, GTU has been empowering young and curating minds to realize their true potential. Over 4 lakh inspired students are enrolled with one of the premier academic universities in India. With more than 450 affiliated colleges in its fold operating across 5 zones of the state, GTU, the International Innovative University, your place to move forward.
You need to do few things. First, you need to inform your user. Hello. You need to inform your user that you are tracing the location of user. Another thing, if it is necessary, then and only then you need to find out the position of your user. And third thing, you should provide option to your user that they can disable or the revoke back the permission that is granted to you, right? So privacy is always the prime concern of user. But many developers nowadays, if you see the news, right, they are violating this permission, right? Even Google itself is doing this kind of things. So, but when we are writing the application that is related to the map, you always take care the privacy concern of your user. Now, how you can find the position of your user? So for that, one method is there, that is get last known location method, right? That you need to utilize. This method comes from the location manager. So first, what you need to do, location manager dot get last known location provider, right? Within that you need to pass your provider. Now how you can select your provider with the help of criteria or another thing, the specific provider, it is your choice. On our current slide, we are passing the GPS provider. That is the most reliable provider we have, and they provide the accurate position of the user. So that we are utilizing right here, location manager dot GPS provider that we have passed. So here it will return the location object. This location object return, and it include all the information that is available from this particular provider, that can have the time it was obtained. That means when you are obtaining the position of user. Another thing, accuracy of the location found. As we already discussed this topic in our previous lecture, it may be low, medium and high, right? If high accuracy is there, it will provide you the location within the 100 meter. If it is medium, it will provide the location between 100 to 500 meter. And if it is the low accuracy, then it may provide you the location information that is more than 500 meter. So according to that, whatever the accuracy level that your device support, right, it will provide it. Now, it also provide a certain other information, like say that latitude, longitude, bearing, altitude and speed. All these properties, right, that is available with the help of methods of location object. You can utilize the getter method of all these things, and you can retrieve those properties. I have already discussed these properties, that what is bearing is, let's repeat it, right, a person is standing or moving, that specified by the bearing. Latitude, that means that angular distance of a north to south, right, how we are dividing our mother earth, right, that equilaterals, right, that is defined with this thing latitude. Then the longitude, that angular distance that is placed from east to west or east or west from the Greenwich median time, right? So that is the longitude and altitude, right? That will give you the height of the object, right? You are flying within that from the sea level or the ground level. These are the properties that you can retract. Okay, now let's see that how you can create the map based activity. Before I start this topic, I want to say you that to create map based activity to retrieve the API key and generating key store, right, all these techniques are totally changed nowadays, right? This is the bookish thing we are learning, whatever the things that is listed in our reference book. But if you see today's scenario, the entire thing is totally different. When we meet at college, I will show you that practically how to do this thing. But right now we will see all the steps that is listed in your reference book. Okay, we quickly complete this thing, and they have lots of changes when you want to perform this thing practically. Okay, now let's start that how you can create the map based activity. So as we all know, right, to represent something graphically towards user, we need to create activity. So here we will create one activity that is known as the map activity, right, that is able to show you some of the location information, address, and the some of the layouts that represent on that activity. These all things will done using a one special view that is known as the map view. You can create your activities including the interactive map. So this map can be plot using map view. So map view support the annotation using overlays and by pinning views to geographical location. Now what is overlays? Like say that when you use the Google map and you get the direction, so they show the direction path, number of kilometers, traffic, or you search the restaurants near you or the hospital near you, right? So they are just showing you the extra item pins that these things are available on your map. So all these are the overlays, and by pinning views to the geographical location, whatever you are searching or roaming on that particular map, right, that you can show with the help of map view. So map view offer fully programmatical control on map that display, and it allow you to control all the facility what you are showing see in our professional apps like the Google Map you have, right? So you can control zoom, location, display modes, like including the satellite view, or you can say the map view, right? You can convert the on or off the traffic views and street views and all other things that you can see. So all this thing is possible with the help of one special view, that is map view. Now let's say the introduction of map view. What map view is actually include and how you can utilize this thing. So what is map view? You can specify this thing in a one line that it is a user interface element that display maps, right? And map activity, it is the base class to extend from the activity class, and it include map view in that. So it's a specific class, right, that is created to just include map view. So it will provide the background support of the all lifecycle event and the service management that is required to display maps, right? So you are only use this map within map view within your derived activities. So another thing that we have, that is the overlay. So what is overlay? I have just explained in my previous slide, right? It is the class that is used to annotate your map. That means you want to show some extra information about map. A general map is there. Now you want to plot certain things, like say that in a recent days we are facing the corona problems. Now you wish to create one app that will highlight the infected area of your city with red color. So you need to create a canvas and put it at overlay on your map with the some red colors or some highlighted colors you have, right? So this is the possibilities that how you can add extra layers, and you can add any number of layers on your map. Another one, that is the map controller. So it is used to control the map by enabling the central location and zoom level, that how you want to zoom it. It's a different level of zooming that can be done. And if you again make it center, it comes on the center point from where you have started it, right? So this is the map controller. Another one, that is the my location overlay. So it is a special overlay that can be used to display your current position, that where you are and from where you are operating this thing, right? So it just provides, like say that you are just roaming by your car from the starting to the ending destination, right? Source to the destination you want to move. Now you want to track your car location, right? So these option can be utilized over there to denote your current position on your map. So my location overlay, that will display the current position of your overlay or the item position. Now another one, that is again a special one, itemized overlay or the overlay items, whatever you say it, right? So they use together to let you create layer of map markers that display the drawables and associated text. So where you can utilize this thing, like say that you are creating one application for your city and you want to plot some items. Say that you want to display all hospitals or restaurants or coffee shops or schools and etc., right? So for each item, you have created separate pin map marker, or you can simply say the icons, right, that you want to plot on map. So number of map markers you can display using this overlays item. So with the help of that map view, you can deal with all these things to create your map activity. Again, I want to add one thing, that the way of dealing with map activity is changed, but all these theoretical concepts or all these topics are remain same when you work in today's scenario. The way you create the map as well as getting sign your application and getting the map API, it is checked, right? But all the topic that we are discussing right here, it is still set. Do you have any doubt in this particular topic? Please confirm.
No, sir.
Okay. Now, getting your map API key. Now, just see that what I am trying to say in my previous slide, that what is changed nowadays, that start from here. To use map view in your application, you first need to get API key from Android developer site. Now, when this book is written, that map API is totally free. But nowadays you have to pay dollars. And this money is charged or according on the number of requests you send on that API, right? And you need to download this thing from the developer console, Google developer console, right? From where you need to register your email address. Of course, you need to pay money and then you can find this map API keys, right? That you can utilize with the your application. This link are the older one, so if you go over there, it will redirect you on new link. Without API key, map you cannot download it, its title, and used on your maps, right? So till you not download this API key and properly configured it, your map application will not run. So this chapter is theoretically available on our syllabus. You can't do the practicals in a practical examination because they don't allow you to open the internet connection. And when you are not able to connect to the internet, how you are able to download the API keys, right? So we are theoretically discussing. So first thing, you need to register yourself and download the MAP API key. Another thing that you need to obtain this and specify the MD5 fingerprint to certify and sign your application. Now, this process, whatever discussed right here, that is defined according to the Eclipse editor. And you all know, right, we are using Android Studio, right? So these two things is again a different. So how you can sign your application with these two certificates? So two certificates are, one is the debug certificate and another one is the production certificate. So let's see that what is the debug certificate and what is the production certificate. Debug certificate are the certificates that sign your application that for the debugging purpose. That means you are debugging your application for the error solution and the enhancement or the development of your application. So it is not ready to just publish it. Another one, after you have completed all error solutions and all error check and proper testing is done, you are ready to release your application. So you require another certification, and that is known as the production certificate, right? So both certification can be done that will digitally sign your application. Now, from where you can get this debug key store? So just see again, when you are using the Eclipse with ADT, this key store is already available in these directories. In the case of Android Studio, right, that is also debug key store is already there in current user dot Android directory, and debug key store name is already there in Windows directory. In Eclipse case, right, whatever the Windows OS you are using, like 7 or 10, it directory is user, then username. Like say that in our lab PC, we have a MCA and student user. So that you need to write in the this place, and then you have one file dot Android slash debug key store, right? That is the binary file you have to sign your application on debug mode, right? Another one, if you are using XP, right, then this file is available in document and setting where debug key store is there. Again, as path is remain same, but the parent directory is checked. In the case of Linux or the Mac OS, right, they have a key store on your home directory dot Android slash debug dot key store is there, right? So from where you can find your debug certificate to sign your application. Usually what happens when you run, your Android application, that will digitally sign your application on debug mode. But if you wish to sign it for the production, you need to do certain extra tasks. Like say that right here, to generate key store for production, they allow you to use a one key to, that is come with the Eclipse, and you need to run this thing with the help of DOS prompt. This a bold text, right, that you need to pass key tool hyphen list, then the alias, whatever the you want to create for your key, that you need to pass, then hyphen key store and the name of key store that you need to specify. It will prompt you, right, to give the alias password for the MD5 fingerprint, and that you need to save. But we are lucky that we are working with the Android Studio, and in Android Studio under the build menu, right, they provide a one GUI tool to create keys for the production. So it's too easy in Android Studio. When we meet at college, right? At that time, I will show you that how we can do this thing. Again, in a last unit, last chapter is there, how to sign your application and publish it to Play Store. At that time, we again repeat this thing that how we can sign our application and publish it. So at that time, I will just show you the practical of this thing. Now, another thing that once you downloaded the Map API key from the developer console, you need to write this thing in Android manifest file. So in an Android manifest file, within application tag, you need to write meta tag. In meta tag, just see example I have created right here, that is provided by your book, Android name, and the package name you need to specify, com.google.android.geo.api key. Now the API key you need to give. Each application what you registered by with your Gmail ID, it will give you the separate API key for a separate projects, right? So that key need to be registered, and you need to keep it secret, because otherwise what happen, other can also utilize this thing. Again, on the Map API side, right, there are certain settings. You can register it for certain domains or the package that only request come from that particular Android package or the specific domain that can entertain that map request. Other will deny, right? That kind of setting that you can do at developer console side, right? And if you are not doing it over there, then you need to keep this thing secret, right? I am just utilizing this key, whatever is given in your reference book, and it is expired one, right? So don't try to use this one. You have to register your email ID and you need to opt in by yourself. Now, when you use the map, of course, right, you are getting detail from internet. So you have to add one permission in Android manifest file, that is android.permission.internet. Do you have any doubt in this thing? Okay, now let's see that how we can create the map based activity. That is the our final topic we have. Okay, so what we need to do, we need to create a one class that is extended from map activity, and we are creating two activity level variables, that is map view, another one that is the map controller. On map view, we will load our map, and on map controller, we utilize this thing to control the map. That is the how to center the map, how to change the mode or the zooming level and all other things. Now, when on create is done, at that time we will find out our view, right? So find view by ID, r.id.mapview, whatever you have placed on your activity. So it will give you the reference of map view. And just see that we have make it the private and activity level object, right? So that property that we can directly utilize. Now another method that comes with the map activity, that is root display, and it will return boolean. So when this thing is written true and when this method is returning false, so in that particular time when you see the directions, some path, some route, at that time it will display true, otherwise it will return false. Like say that you have, you want to navigate the route between Jamnagar to the Rajkot, and you are traveling using your bike or car, right? So at that time what happened, you are getting the route information. So in that case it will return true, otherwise it will return false. Now just see that how we have created that map view. right, this map layout. On that map layout, we have placed this map view. So how we have placed this XML file? So on a linear layout, one specialized map view class that we are placing. Right? So that is the widgets that you can drag and drop on your linear layout, right? And we have specified certain things. Just see that these are the depreciated properties you are seeing on your screen, because I have just taken this code from your reference book, right? Field parent. Nowadays we are using which thing? Match parent. Okay. Another two things, that is Android enable. That means your map is enabled. Clickable, that you are able to click on the item available on map. And another thing that just see the API key. So my map API key that you have registered in your manifest file. Just see in a manifest, we are placing this information, right? So that map API key you are referring from that. Now how to configure your map where you can show your current position. So let's configure the map view. It's depend on your choice that which type of view you want to display. But by default, map view show the standard street map. But we can configure it as per our need. Like say that we are not interested in street map, but we want to see the satellite view. So you need to fire some of the setter method, say map view dot set satellite. That is true. Then it will convert your view from street to the satellite. Now after the satellite view, if you wish to create it, convert it into the street, then another method is there, set street view, and you need to pass through over there, it will convert it into the street map. Another one, that set traffic equal to true, right? So it will display the traffic information. How you can get the maximum zoom capacity of map view, and what are the current zoom level in your map. So again, two getter methods are there. Get max zoom level, so it will give you the maximum zoom capacity, and get zoom level, that will give you the current zoom level. Another one, that is the how you can get the center point of your map, right? When you do the centering of your map, right, then this feature can be utilized. So geo point center equal to map view dot get map center, right? So it will center the your item that is moving right into the center of map. Now how to get the currently visible latitude and longitude, right? So again, a getter method is there, map view dot get latitude span and longitude span, that will give you the integer information of latitude and longitude. Another one, if you wish to show the built-in zoom controls over there, then you can utilize another method, that is set built-in zoom control true. So it will display the standard map zoom control that you can utilize to control the zoom. But if you wish to create your own controllers, right, then zoom button controller object can be created, and you can utilize the instance of it. So how you can get this thing? So map view dot get zoom button controller, that will give you the plus and minus and all of the things, right, that to control the zoom. Now how we can plot our position on map view, right? So map controller that we can get using the get controller method of the map view, that will provide you the map controller that can be utilized to refer or the reference of map views the control. Now here you need to note one thing, that when you want to plot your latitude and longitude on map view, right, that represent in Android using geo points. So which contain latitude and longitude measures in micro degrees. So first you need to convert your latitude and longitude into micro degree. So question is that how we can convert this thing in micro degree, right? So to convert this thing, we need to multiply our latitude and longitude into 1E6. That means 1 and 6 zeros, that is followed by this thing. Okay, so just see the example given is here. Double latitude and longitude are there, and we are multiplying this thing. This is the San Francisco latitude and longitude. So we are converting our latitude and longitude into the micro degrees. Now this can be utilized to plot on screen. So just see geo point, we are creating new geo point, and the micro degree integer value we are getting over here, because the constructor of geo point that will take the integer value. So latitude int value and longitude int value that we are passing. So it will plot the point on map view of the current position of your map. Now if you want to recenter it, it might possible that you are seeing the map of India right now and you plot the point on San Francisco. So what happened? You are unable to see that particular point. So another task that you need to do to recenter your map. So to do the center of your map, you need to fire certain method that you can see in a bold text on our current slide. That is the map controller dot set center and point parameter you need to pass over there. And then you can set the zooming level. It is from 1 to 8 zooming level are there, right? That you can utilize what you practice on Google Map, that can be applied. Same thing right here. So map controller dot set zoom that we are setting 1. Now what happened? When you recentered it, right, it rigidly move your controller to that particular point. To make these smooth transitions, you can utilize the another method available in Android, that is the animate2, and a point parameter you need to pass, right? So it will smoothly jump from current location to the new location with the help of animation. So you will see the smooth transition to point your map position on map view. So that's all that content we have, that how you can point your current position on map view, right? So that's all with this unit. Unit number 4 is completed right here. If you have any doubt, you can ask your questions. Do you have any doubt?
Sir, practical karao so ne avada.
બધાનું પ્રેક્ટિકલ થશે, પણ એક્ચ્યુઅલમાં એવું છે કે એન્ડ્રોઇડ સ્ટુડિયો મારા પીસીમાં બી બહુ જ સ્લો ચાલે છે રેમના હિસાબે, એટલે આપણે લેબની અંદર આ બધા જ ટાસ્ક છે કરશું. ને છતાંય જો
સર લેબમાં જ આવી રીતના નહીં સર, આમાં તો કામ મજા નહીં આવે, લેક્ચરમાં વચ્ચે વચ્ચે નેટવર્ક ઓલું થઈ જાય છે.
હા હું સમજી શકું છું, એટલે જ અત્યારે આપણે પહેલા થિયરી કમ્પ્લીટ કરીએ છીએ અને છેલ્લે આપણે પ્રેક્ટિકલ રાખીએ. પણ ઇન કેસ જો લોકડાઉન એક્સટેન્ડ થશે તો રોજની એક એક્સરસાઇઝ આપણે જે છે અહીંયા કરશું, કારણ કે તો આપણી પાસે કોઈ ઓપ્શન હશે નહીં. બરાબર?
હા સર.
બનશે ત્યાં સુધી આપણે લેબમાં જ કરવા છે, કારણ કે અહીંયા જ પોસિબલ થાય એમ છે. પણ જો લોકડાઉન એક્સટેન્ડ થયું, ધેન વી ડઝ નોટ હેવ એની ચોઇસ, વી હેવ ટુ ડુ રાઈટ હિયર. ઓકે?
હા સર.
ઓકે. Now, next unit, right, એ હું કાલે તમને કરાવીશ. આજે 10 મિનિટ હું તમને વેલા ફ્રી કરી દઉં છું. નવું યુનિટ છે, નવા લેક્ચર થી આપણે સ્ટાર્ટ કરશું. હવે 3 ચેપ્ટર આપણા બાકી રહેશે. ઓકે?
યસ સર.
ઇફ યુ હેવ એની ડાઉટ યુ કેન આસ્ક, અધરવાઇઝ આઈ વિલ જસ્ટ કમ્પ્લીટ ધીસ મીટિંગ.
સર અત્યારે નથી, પ્રેક્ટિકલ કરશું તો એ ખબર પડશે.
ઓકે 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 બાય. એનીબડી એલ્સ ઇફ યુ હેવ ડાઉટ ધેન આસ્ક, અધરવાઇઝ આઈ એમ જસ્ટ એન્ડિંગ ધીસ મીટિંગ. ઓકે બાય.